Hi guys. So I meant to do this last weekend. I'm just getting to it now. I've got my Tony of Beverly Aubrey wig and I wanted to do what I said I would try to do. I think I said I would try to do it. Take it out of the box. I should have had this out already. I'd already put it back in the box. So when I did the review on it, I loved everything about it except for just the weft that was showing in the front. And I'll put a link to that video down below so that you know what I'm talking about if you haven't seen that. I'm just going to use a styrofoam head for now. So here's the wig. And yeah, sorry, just checking. It was just this one area at the front, really. Just, you know, if just felt like if the wind blew really hard and, you know, first of all, where it's really white, where it's showing right through the styrofoam, if you had a black wig cap on or darker hair underneath, that would solve that problem altogether. But we've still got the weft, that brown there. So what I wanted to do was get out a needle and thread and see if I can make a difference just by sewing that together closer, just doing maybe 3 stitches. I don't know, I've never done this before. So I don't have my glasses here. I'm going to need that for sure to do something with my little sewing kit. It's a really old Peak Frame tin. This is my grandmother's. Oh, Forrest is he's making some noise. He's okay. He's doing much better. He's not making that noise quite as much, and he gets over it more quickly, as you know, he's already over it, so that's great. So I guess there was an old sticker on here. The old Peak Freen and Company. I love old tins. And especially, you know, it's a little bit bashed up and everything, but it was my grandmother's, which is my mother's mother's, and I just love it. So I keep my sewing stuff in here. I keep them in a couple of different tins. But, yeah, so I'm going to have to go get my glasses because there's no way I'm getting a thread through one of these needles without it. But I will, let's see, I've got black thread, but let's see if I've got a chocolate brown one. I think the black one's a good one because you camouflage, and you can also, if I make a mistake, maybe it'll be easier to just pull on the thread instead of cutting something else. All right. Let me get this needle threaded and see if I can figure this out and get my glasses too. Okay, hang on. Okay, so I've put on wig caps, the dark wig cap, just to show you the difference already. See, now the only thing you see is the weft. You're not seeing right there. That used to be what you would see right through to the white styrofoam, or when I did my wig video, that was my beige wig cap, so that really showed through. So it's a lot. Well, the light's really picking it up still. You can still see that that weft. So what I'm going to try to do, because I don't know if I'm going to be able to film this. It's going to take me a while to do, and I don't think you want to watch that. I'm going to pull that together and do a stitch there. Maybe do a stitch there. And maybe over here. Like probably 3 stitches is all it's going to take. And I think I want to stitch them so I'll do it inside out so the knots and a little bit of extra thread is going to be on the inside of the cap. So, not that it would show I'm using black thread, but still, you don't want the thread out here. So, I'll do it on the inside. And that way, I'm not risking cutting the hair when I cut the thread either. Brilliant. So, step one is wearing a darker wig cap, or if your own hair is dark enough, mine would be dark enough. That camouflages the whole. But I'm probably going to be sewing that closed anyway, but all right, I'll be back. All right, I don't know if this is going to be helpful or not. I'll just film a little bit. I may not even include this, but I'm just holding it there. I'm going to put my finger on the weft and take the wig off just so I know where it is that the problem is when I go to sew it. And so there it is. And on the inside, you know what it is? It's turning it inside out. It's here. right where that meets, where the front, where everything's sewn on the front, everything's sewn here, it's just where the rest of the wig cap meets that area there, the moleskin, that's what it's called. All right, so, oh, I still haven't threaded my needle yet. All right, I've never filmed like this before, so I hope you can see it. I'm using blue thread, just so it'll show a bit more where I want it to. And so that's that front edge. And there's that sort of, can you even see that? So you've got the open area, on either side there's the lace in the middle. So I'm gonna stitch this to there. I'm gonna do it for me. Inside, and I'm so sorry if you can't see this because I can't do this and also make sure that you can see it either, but I'm trying. Hang on. So I'm coming from the inside of the wig. Where am I? Can't even see the needle. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna pop up. You see that? Hang on. Okay, so the needle I've got right about there. Pull that through. I haven't got a very long thread here. Just doing enough to leave a bunch of thread inside, and I'm just going to tie one, not do one stitch. I'm going to take it to the front of this and go in. Then and then I'm gonna hold what's on the other side, pull this through. I didn't go very long, so now I've just got this thread. This is probably the wrong way to do it. I wish I had nice nails. It'd be so nice. It's so much nicer if I had those pretty hands and nails that everyone who does makeup and everything has. Okay. Wow, this thread is slippery. I'm tying a knot, you'd think it would stick, and it's just not. So, alright, so that was the first tie. Hang on, you can't even see. Oh, cheap thread. Yeah, just broke. Nice. All right, well, this is going to give me an idea if that one stitch made a difference. And it did. Did so. This is where, right here, used to be as open as there. So now I'm just going to take a stitch. Pull that part up there, stitch that together, and I'm going to do that off camera because well, first I've got to get better thread, and then, see, that just came right out altogether. So that's it back out again. So I'm going to get some better thread. I'm going to do probably about 3 stitches, and then I'll show you afterwards on the mannequin head. Terrible. It'd be so much better if I knew how to sew.
Hi guys, I'm just trying to download the video that I made this afternoon. That's why I'm lying on the couch here. And what I did was too long, so this is going to be part one, and I'm going to post this, and then I'll post part two. Sorry about that. What was it? It was about 13 minutes altogether, and somehow that was just too much. I don't know if it's YouTube or if it's my iPad that just conks out after a certain amount of time trying to download. So, anyway. I wonder if I can make my neck look better. Not really. Well, I tried. All right. See you at part 2.